Well, good morning and welcome. The Lord invites us to come out of our busy lives to a quiet time and place this morning. Our souls thirst for some peace and quiet, so come and rest in the Lord, who will restore our souls. Our lives need moments of rest where we can sit with the Father and find refreshment in Him. Let's pray. Lord, we gather here this morning with lives that are filled with activity and movement. We rush from one thing to another as though we are going to run out of time to accomplish everything. Help us to let go of the hectic times and the stresses and find our rest in You. Relax our spirits and refresh our souls. Remind us that there will always be things to do and places to go, but we need the rest of spirit that You provide. We thank You for Your compassion that is ever present in our lives. And so we commit this time to You, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Everything to God in prayer. During this lockdown, there might be so many things that are bothering you, that are stopping you from rejoicing in the Lord always. Let us pray. God who heals, we come to You in our brokenness, in our despair, in the hopelessness of the world. We know that You take up our burdens when we feel the weight of the world on us and feel that we are lost in the valley of the shadow. We have a hard time feeling Your presence with us. Become known to us, O God, May we feel your presence in the most difficult times. May we feel your healing when we feel most vulnerable. Help us to reach out to one another in our prayers and have compassion towards each other, that we may bear each other's burdens and help one another to know your presence. In the name of Christ, who makes us one, we pray all things. Amen. Dear friends, God restores our soul. God leads us in the paths of righteousness and prepares a place for us and blesses us even in the most difficult times. God loves us and he promises to never abandon us. The good news is we are forgiven. On behalf of the Lord Jesus Christ, I declare to you that you are forgiven in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen.
Ephesians 2:11-22. Therefore, remember that formerly you who are Gentiles by birth and called uncircumcised by those who call themselves the circumcision, which is done in the body by human hands, remember that at that time you were separate from Christ, excluded from citizenship in Israel, and foreigners to the covenant of the promise, without hope and without God in the world. But now, in Christ Jesus, you who once were far away have been brought near by the blood of Christ. For he himself is our peace, who has made the two groups one and has destroyed the barrier, the dividing wall of hostility, by setting aside in his flesh the law with its commands and regulations. His purpose was to create in himself one new humanity out of the two, thus making peace, and in one body to reconcile both of them to God through the cross, by which he put to death their hostility. He came and preached peace to you who were far away and peace to those who were near. For through him we both have access to the Father by one Spirit. Consequently, you are no longer foreigners and strangers, but fellow citizens with God's people, and also members of his household, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the chief cornerstone. In him the whole building is joined together and rises to become a holy temple in the Lord. And in him you too are being built together to become a dwelling in which God lives by his Spirit.
The reading today is from the New Living Translation, Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I have all that I need. He lets me rest in green meadows. He leads me beside peaceful streams. He renews my strength. He guides me along right paths, bringing honour to his name. Even when I walk through the darkest valley, I will not be afraid, for you are close beside me. Your rod and your staff protect and comfort me. You prepare a feast for me in the presence of my enemies. You honour me by anointing my head with oil. My cup overflows with blessings. Surely goodness and unfailing love will pursue me all the days of my life, and I will live in the house of the Lord forever.
See the way, When the shadows surround me, I will not be afraid. For I know you are with me, you will always provide. Though the path may be lonely, you will stay by my side. Trust in you alone, for the Lord my shepherd leads me, leads me, and he is all I need. In the darkest valley,
join me in the offering prayer. Thank you, Lord God, that you have called us into the flock of Jesus. Make us like our good shepherd, so that we have compassion on people, helping them in their needs and leading them to Jesus. Use us and our possessions in your service. Amen.
The apostles gathered around Jesus and reported to him all they had done and taught. Then because so many people were coming and going that they didn't even have a chance to eat. He said to them, "Come with me by yourselves to a quiet place and get some rest." So they went away by themselves in a boat to a solitary place. But many who saw them leaving recognized them and ran on foot from all the towns and got there ahead of them. When Jesus landed and saw a large crowd, he had compassion on them because they were like sheep without a shepherd. So he began teaching them many things. When they had crossed over, they landed at Gennesaret and anchored there. As soon as they got out of the boat, people recognized Jesus. They ran throughout that whole region and carried the sick on mats to wherever they heard he was. And wherever he went, into villages, towns, or countryside, they placed the sick in the marketplaces. They begged him to let them touch even the edge of his cloak, and all who touched it were healed.
Grace and peace from God our Father through Jesus Christ our Lord be with us all. Dear friends, if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost. Paul's second letter to the Corinthians 4:3. Reminds me of a village Sunday school entertainment Sunday, where everyone got together in this small church, and the place was crowded and in darkness as a movie was being played at the exhibition. A knock at the door summoned an usher who made his way to the front and announced, "Little Mary is lost. Her family and the town officers have been searching everywhere for her. If anyone has seen her or knows of her whereabouts, will you please go to the door and communicate with the friend who is inquiring?" No one moved out, for people were watching the movie very seriously and they were engrossed in it. Now at the close, when the lights were turned on, a lady noticed Mary sitting on a front seat. Now she went over to her and she said, "Why, Mary, didn't you hear them inquiring for you? Why did you not tell them that you were here?" Surprised, the child asked, "Did they mean me? Did they really mean me?" They said Mary Jones was lost. "I am not lost. I knew where I was all the time. I thought it was some other Mary." My dear friends, how many of us have been in a similar situation? The world around us thinks that we are lost, but we think we are not. At times, the people around us see things better than us, and at times, we see things better than those around us. Now, Mary was lost in this crowd and did not know that she was lost. There are so many in this world who are lost, who are like sheep without a shepherd. And today, God speaks to us through this story, through Jesus and his disciples who wanted to go away to a quiet place. The theme for today is God gathers the lost and he feeds them with grace, peace, and love. Dear friends, how many times have someone come to you and said, "Are you lost?" How many times have you felt I am far from my loved ones and I feel I'm all by myself. Have you ever felt lonely, lost, or longing to see a loved one, or longing for something that you've lost? In my pastoral care visits, I have seen many who have been lost, who feel that God is too far away from them, who have said, I think God is too far away from me that he doesn't answer me. We fail to realize that it is we who go far away from God, and we end up in a deserted place, in a lonely place. There might be times when we were hurt by our loved ones, by our friends, by people around us, and we go and hide ourselves to avoid anyone hurting us. And we end up building walls and leading a lonely life. There might be times when we gossip and we hurt others, that there are people who don't want to come out of their homes, of their caves. They lock themselves just the way today we are locked down. And during this lockdown, might be some of us feel that we can't go anywhere. We keep building walls when we are hurt by others, and we try to turn out to become selfish and lost in our own world. And added to that, we have the social media. We have our cell phones that keeps us glued and locked in our own world. Someone said, phones have made people lock themselves in their own cells and they are lost in their world. No wonder phones are called cell phones, because they imprison you in a cell. Loneliness and depression is becoming a big issue for all ages. Previously, it used to be more for those who are aged or after retirement. But now, it's become very common. In the Gospel of Mark chapter 6, 31, Jesus says, let us go away to a deserted place and take some rest. Now Jesus and the disciples were always among the crowd and they wanted to get some rest. They wanted to get away from the hustle and bustle and just go to a lonely place, to a deserted place and get some rest. But the crowd followed Jesus and the disciples, and they waited for him at the shore. As Jesus went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and as he saw them, he had compassion for them, because they were like sheep without a shepherd. And he began to teach them many things. Dear friends, Jesus recognized that these people were lost and were feeling deserted. He saw them like sheep without a shepherd. It's interesting that Jesus and his disciples wanted to go to a deserted place for some rest. But they come to a place where they find not a deserted place, but a crowd of deserted people, longing for peace, longing for grace, hope, and love. Now Jesus drew them nearer to him by teaching them the word of God. He taught them many things. Firstly, he preached the word, and then he provided a meal to fetch their hunger. Dear friends, God knows our needs. During this time of lockdown, God knows our needs. He feeds us with His word. He feeds us every day, every meal, that we may be strengthened with His presence, with His word, with His love. This is the good news, my dear friends, that Jesus has compassion on each one of you during this time. Jesus comes to us and to everyone that we may be saved, that we may be found in times when we are lost. There are so many into depression and people who are lost and feel caged in their own cells. And God craves, His heart craves, His heart cries out, for He has compassion on us to save us, to save the lost, to seek the lost that we may be found. And He just doesn't find us, but He goes one step further in finding us, feeding us, and healing us. And that's what He does in today's gospel reading. Paul shares the good news in Ephesians chapter 2, 13 to 21. He says, "But now in Christ Jesus, you who were once far off have been brought near by the blood of Christ. For He is our peace, and in His flesh He has made both groups into one and has broken down the dividing wall, that is, the hostility between us." This is good news, my dear friends. Praise God that we are no longer lost or far away from God, but through the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and through His body and blood, we who were once far off have been brought near to Him. We who have once been lost have been found by our compassionate Savior, a shepherd who will never leave us nor forsake us. It might be as though we are walking in the valley of shadow of death, but we have no fear because God is with us, God Emmanuel. Paul continues to share the good news by saying, "So He came and proclaimed peace to you who were far off and peace to those who were near. And through Him, both of us have access in one spirit to the Father." This is good news, my dear friends. "That in whom you also are built together spiritually into a dwelling place for God." You are built spiritually into a dwelling place for God. And all of us are fed by His word. And He heals us that we may be restored to life, life eternal. May you be blessed by His word and know that Jesus has compassion on you. And if you feel you're lost, just know that you've been found by Christ, our Savior. And He continues to seek each one of us that we may be found and that we may have joy and peace. And now may God's peace that passes all understanding guard our hearts and minds through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now
Let's pray. Our God cares for his people and sends shepherds to feed, protect, guide and nurture them. Our God shepherd, Jesus Christ, knows each of us by name. Let us pray to our shepherd who is always with us. Thank you, Lord Jesus, our good shepherd, for calling us into your flock. Have compassion on your people and purify the teaching of your church. Remove the poison of cultural accommodation and expediency. Expose our errors, forgive us and bring us to repentance and renewal. Have compassion on our brothers and sisters in other Christian churches at this time. Remove the error that divides us. Direct our discussions and decisions about cooperation and strengthen our love for one another. We pray for all who rule and govern, that they may be fair and compassionate shepherds of their people. Have compassion on this land and send rain where it is needed. Prosper all proper work and learning and bless the teachers and children in our schools. Have mercy on all who are in need, dear Lord, and shepherd them. Bring peace where there is trouble, food where there is hunger, hope where there is despair, and soften our hearts to have compassion and help where we can. Good Shepherd, support each of us here in our daily lives. Give us strength and skill for our work, love for our families, righteousness in our thinking and doing. Have compassion on all who are sick or stressed. Heal and restore them and give them confidence in you. And meet the needs of others we know personally to be in need and whom we now name silently in our hearts. Merciful God, as your Son heard the cries of the people for him to heal them, hear our prayers according to your grace, so that your grace throughout the world. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please join with me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
You are God's beloved people, refreshed, restored, forgiven, and healed. Go now into this world, confined in the gifts God has given you. Go to serve God's people, bringing words of peace and hope to all whom you meet. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favour and give you his peace. Amen.